I just dreamt that someone kidnapped our baby.
I'm here, and I will never leave you. I will protect you and our baby.
I'll be back, and I will make all of them pay.
I hired a private investigator to look for Alex. I want to know where she is.
That's her. She's the one who sold me fake jewelry.
Ma'am, you're
under arrest. Officer, you've got the wrong person. I can't go to jail. I didn't do anything wrong.
I hope she understands where I'm coming from, especially now that she's going to be a mother. No mother would ever want to lose her child.
Why not try your luck first here in Japan?
Who knows? I might be able to give my daughter a better life here.
How about Edward?
Have you seen him?
Did you talk to him?
He's the reason why you went there.
You're here in Korea for a good reason. And that's because your career will be better here. Please move on.
This is all your fault, Kara. You took my brother away from me. You're the reason why my life is ruined.
I was just thinking about Sara. She'll be giving birth soon.
She has her own life in Japan.
But when will she come back?
Are you sure that you can still work? You look like you're going to blow up. What's the matter?
I think I'm about to give birth.
What?
I wonder how she is. I really hope she's doing okay.
We all know how Sara is, right? She's the bravest woman that I have ever known.
Rebecca, your mother's right here. You're a strong girl, just like your mother, right? Just keep fighting, okay?
What are you doing here?
I came here to collect.
Until you make things right, I can't accept you. I will not put my family at risk because of you.
You're a traitor, Kara. You didn't just steal my brother from me, but our house as well. And you've stolen my chances to be with my brother. You've taken everything from me.
That's right, Rebecca. Be strong, okay? You need to be strong for your mother now.
OMG, it's time!
Oh, Seb.
It's time!
Oh, Seb, hurry!
I'm on it!
Anyway, I brought you some snacks. Here you go. I asked permission from your doctor if I can join you in here to eat. And I'm really glad she agreed, because I had a feeling that you'd be missing this by now. There. And I brought your favorite cupcakes, too. Here. Go on, have a little bite. I remember when you were young. You were always so conscious about your health, just like your dad was. And your dad loved these, remember? You remember? You and him usually got together in the kitchen. Even in the middle of the night, you would sneak into the kitchen so that the two of you could bake a whole lot of different cupcakes.
And then the next morning, you would wonder why the kitchen is so messy and all. After that, you'd scold Anita for the mess. Even then, Dad and I would pretend that we had nothing to do with it. We were such good partners in crime.
And I would get so mad. But I would always tell myself, I should just let these two do whatever it is they want to. Because I could see just how happy you two were. Especially when you were happy ganging up on me.
But then Dad is gone now. He left us, didn't he, Mom? He left us for another family, right? Seb's family took Dad away from us.
But the two of us loved you, Lucille. With all our hearts. Especially me. I did everything to make you feel that you were complete, despite what happened between me and your dad.
That's what you think, Mom. But I was so broken. And that's why, from that fated day on, I promised myself that I'd have a complete and happy family of my own. And that is why I want Kara back, especially now that she's having a child of her own.
Oh, Seb! Seb, I'm so scared!
Kara, I'm right here, okay? And we're at the hospital now. Everything will be fine, okay?
Seb!
Kara. I know our baby will be fine. Remember, she's excited to come out. I know she will make it easy for you. I'm sure of it. Okay?
Seb, please. Please don't leave me right now.
No,
please.
I wouldn't do
I'm
that.
So
no. I'll be here. I won't leave you, I promise.
Please.
Of course.
I'm really sorry, Mrs. Acosta, but Lucille needs to have her rest right now.
All right. Here, take this with you. Doctor, I'm really worried about Lucille's condition. She's not getting any better. She becomes very happy, then she suddenly turns very sad.
Based on our observations and tests, Lucille is suffering from a combination of psychosis and delusions. And one of the symptoms of her condition is extreme mood swings, which sometimes becomes extreme anger, which in turn could lead to violence. And because of her hallucinations, or detachment from reality, we decided to give Lucille further treatment.
But I'm sure that there's a cure for Lucille's condition, right?
As for now, we just need to proceed with her treatment, and we would need to observe her every day. There will be further laboratory tests and psychological evaluations. We'll take it from there after all these tests.
How long will Lucille's treatments last anyway?
It could take a few months or even years. But Mrs. Acosta, we are doing everything we can. I must say, it will be very difficult because we didn't treat her right away. It might be a difficult process. See, in some cases, the patient's recovery depends upon their own will.
Hey, be careful, girl. Come on, give Rebecca to me. I'll be the one to carry her. Do you know how to take care of a baby?
I'm fine, really. I'm all right. Besides, I'm trying to learn.
Oh, come on, Sarah. Who do you think you're asking? You think I can't take care of a child? I have a lot of relatives in the Philippines, you know. I took care of all of my nieces and nephews.
Let me do it on my own. Besides, it's my baby after all. And on top of that, I think I'm getting the hang of this.
You sure about that?
Of course.
You see, I've been noticing that lately you seem to be very weak, Sarah. That's no surprise. You've barely recovered, and yet the first chance you get, you head straight back to work.
It's really not an issue. And besides, it just feels so good to carry her. I feel like a real mom. It's like, even if I get weak, Rebecca here will give me strength. And when I spoke to the doctor, he told me to make sure that Rebecca is breastfed. It's unbelievable. So this is what it feels like, huh? It feels so good to be a mom and to hold your baby in your arms. It really makes you crazy. It's like you want to laugh and cry at the same time. And even if you're hurting, you just can't help but to smile.
What are you planning to do then? Aren't you even going to let your parents know? Won't you let them see your baby at all? I'm sorry I asked. To be honest, though, I can't exactly give you my word that I would always be here. I have a job, too, as you well know.
Come on, don't worry about it. And besides, you've been a huge help to me. Just letting me stay here is already a big deal, you know?
Then what exactly are you planning to do anyway? I'm asking because you're running out of money for your baby's medication.
Oh, she just smiled now. All I know for sure is that I'm really going to work hard for my daughter. I'm willing to do everything for Rebecca. We'll stay here now. This is the place where we'll get a new start. And I promise that she will never experience what I've been through. And she will never feel incomplete, even if it's just the two of us. I will give my daughter all of my love in my heart. Oh, Rebecca. Your mother will be here for you forever.
Mama?
Mother! That's what I called my mother as a kid. It makes sense.
Okay, Mama. Oh, but what about Rebecca's father, huh? I mean, isn't there any update on her father at all? He should be helping you out, you know.
No idea. He just disappeared into thin air. I've even tried his bandmates, but I can't seem to reach any of them either.
Okay, Kara, push! You have to keep pushing, Kara, and you have to push harder! Push! Come on, Kara, push harder! Push! Push, Kara, push!
What's the matter?
The umbilical cord is coiled around the baby's neck. Kara, I need your help. Push harder! I need you to push harder, Kara! I need you to push harder! I need your help! Push harder, Kara!
I wonder how Kara's doing.
Don't worry, Laura. We have to trust the doctors.
He's right, Laura. And you know what? You're way too tense. You should try to relax. Besides, now you're starting to freak me out, too. I feel like I'm also giving birth right now.
That's just probably gas pain you're experiencing. Wait, do you want to go to the restroom?
Oh, stop it. Fact is, I'm her godparent. I mean, I am Kara's second mother, so I also feel whatever Laura's feeling.
What? Are you kidding me right now? You're more tense than Aunt Laura. How much coffee did you drink?
Oh, will you shut it?
Hello? Yes, doctor. Okay, doctor. DR1.
Okay.
DR1?
Miss, tell us what's happening.
Any news?
What's going on?
It would be better if you called your parents, you know. It's really hard being a single mother. It won't be as hard if you're just at home, but you're a working girl. Go ahead and call your parents. Swallow your pride for once.
Okay, Kara, one last push.
Come on, Kara, you're doing great.
Okay, the baby's out.
Doctor, how's our baby doing?
She's a beautiful baby girl.
Kara, you and I are parents now. Mom, Dad,
Seb, how's Kara doing? What's going
on?
What's
happening?
Well, Kara had a rough time in there.
What?
But the delivery was a success. And Kara is safe now. And our baby is safe as well.
Hey, Seb, what does the baby look like?
Yes, tell us.
She's perfect. She looks just like Kara.
Wow! Yes. She's a goddess! Our granddaughter is a goddess!
Yes,
that's amazing!
Yes, that's great!
Congratulations!
Yes. Congratulations, this is so wonderful!
Congrats, Seb!
I have a granddaughter! This is so fabulous!
Baby.
She's fine. Kara, she's perfect.
Hi, Mother. Hi, Father.
Is she awake? Oh! Ooh.
How are you feeling, Kara?
Goodness gracious, Kara!
How are you?
I'm fine.
Congratulations, Kara. You did a good job in there, right, guys?
Have you seen my baby yet?
No, we haven't seen your baby yet. Mm. But I'm so excited.
So am I. Oh my goodness, you're amazing, Kara. I can't wait to see the baby. Seb here says she looks just like Kara.
That's true.
She didn't get any of your features. Oh, hey, I think that's her.
Oh.
There she is.
Oh, the baby's here.
Oh. Time to meet your mommy.
Oh, she's so beautiful.
Shh. Just look at her.
Baby.
Aw, the baby's crying.
Look at that.
Oh, Karam.
She's so cute.
Your mother's here.
She's so beautiful.
Yeah.
Shh, shh, shh. Oh, look at that. I think she wants to be carried. Oh, she's a princess. She wants to be carried. Oh, to be fair, you guys. Look, so guys, beautiful. Look at her eyes. They're like Kara's. But she has the same nose as you. But in the end, she looks like her mother. Good for you, Kara. Oh, just look at those legs. She has the legs of a beauty queen, doesn't she?
Exactly.
You're right, Kara. Your baby's beautiful.
May I?
Oh, of course.
Say hi to Daddy.
Here's your daddy.
Watch your head. All right, be careful.
Oh, you know, Seb's been practicing.
Is that right? It shows, right?
Oh, it's okay.
Oh, hey.
He's your daddy.
Hey. Oh, she's talking to her dad.
She likes daddy. Look at her.
Isabella.
Her name is Isabella?
Oh.
Isabella.
Now that's the name of a future beauty queen. Oh, Isabella Acosta. Philippines! Oh, goodness gracious! Her name's like a beauty queen's, right, guys? But what should she call me? What's godmother and mom she rolled into one?
Baby!
Excuse me, miss. Miss, what are you doing in this room? It's a restricted area.
You left the door open with my niece in here. What if something happened to her? Is this how you run this place, carelessly?
I'm really sorry, ma'am. It won't happen again.
It better not. If it does, I'll file a complaint against you. Hello, baby girl Acosta. You're so lucky, you know that. Everything that Kara stole from me will be all yours. Money, a bright future, as well as my brother's love. A good life probably awaits you, where you'll have nothing to worry about. Because when you get out of here, you're going to be with your family.
Sarah, hurry up. Our customers are waiting, and the boss is in a bad mood right now.
Give me a second. My hands are just really full right now. There are so many dishes to do.
Sarah, are you sure you can still do your job? See, you gave birth just a few days ago, and now you're already back at work? And I've noticed that you've been getting weaker and weaker lately.
I feel fine. I just need some coffee. Don't worry, I'll feel better after I've had my coffee.
Fine, but hurry up, all right?
What are you doing? Talking and talking? Do your job.
Yes, sir. Don't worry. I will do fast, faster, fastest. Go, go. Sayonara.
Sarah, you slow. If you not go fast, you will say sayonara to Japan and I will not pay you.
Ta-da!
Wait, she might cry.
Wow, guys, you really shouldn't have bothered.
What? But Seb, of course we had to. I mean, she's your first child, right? And besides, our princess needs her welcome home party.
Thank you very much, everyone.
My gosh, she's so cute.
Baby Isabella, I'm your Uncle Andy. the handsomest uncle that you will ever have.
Oh, come on, Andy. You know that you're her only uncle, right? It's not like you're competing with anyone.
How are you feeling?
I'm fine, thank you. Actually, all the exhaustion and pain went away as soon as I held Isabella here.
Oh, she's so beautiful.
Oh, my goodness. I forgot about Rebecca. Hello, Andrea.
Hello, Sarah. I'm so glad you called. Your baby won't stop crying right now.
Oh no, why? What happened?
I really don't know, girl. I gave her some milk. I changed her soiled diapers. I even sang her a lullaby, but she won't stop crying. Maybe she's looking for you.
And girl, I need to get ready or I'm going to be late for work. Oh, Andrea, I'm really sorry, all right?
But what about my job, huh? Sarah, our boss docks our pay. Whenever we're late, is there any chance you can reimburse me for that? And I'd appreciate it. If it's okay with you, maybe you could compensate me for taking care of your daughter.
Hey, you know what? Why don't you put me on speakerphone so that Rebecca can hear me? Maybe she'll stop crying then.
All right, girl. Rebecca, it's your mother.
Now don't worry, I'm almost done with work and I'll be home really soon, all right? Mother will be home very soon. So don't cry, okay? You don't want to make things hard for Andrea, after all. All right, Rebecca? Mother's coming home, okay? I love you. I finished washing. Can I go now? My baby is sick.
No, you cannot go home. You see many people today. Help serve today. Go, go, go! Change, go!
Sir, but...
No, go change. Go serve.
Granddaughter is so beautiful, right?
Oh.
What's wrong? Are you thinking about Sara?
I wonder how your sister is doing. I hope she's okay in Japan.
She's probably given birth too. I just wish she was here with us.
I wish that they were both with us, so that her baby can be with her cousin. Now that would be so much fun. To see my grandchildren under one roof. Oh, look, she just smiled at me.
Oh.
I think I saw someone outside.
From?
Alex.
From Alex? Welcome home. How did she know I'd already given birth?
Maybe Alex just never stopped following us.
I think she's trying to reach out through Isabella. Maybe she's hoping that you'll change her mind about her.
Even if I want her back in my life right now, I'm still scared that someday I might regret that decision. She might do something much worse to us.
Yeah.
Hey, Sarah, serve this to table 3.
Oh, all right. Hey, what's with that Japanese guy? He has so many demands so early in the day.
That's just how he celebrates. He is a friend of the owner and he has a lot of money. Now hurry, we're expecting some more customers later.
All right, all right. Sir?
Oh.
Thank you.
Ishinigidoromashu.
Sir?
Let's dance!
Oh, no, 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 no dance. No dance.
何か問題あるの? 踊りましょう! 踊ろう! Dance!
Oh, sir, I'm not a dancer. I'm only a waitress.
Waitress? いくら? お金あげるから? How much? What can I give you?
No, no, no. No dance. Sorry, sir.
Wait. 踊りましょう! 踊りましょう!
Sir, no, no.
踊りましょう! 何君は? What did you do? You go to jail!
Sir, sir, please, no jail. Please, I'm begging you, no jail. I'm sorry.
You hurt me! You go to jail!
Mr. Takeshi, kono otabi wa moshi wakarimasen. Kanojo wa atarashi desu. She knows nothing. Watashi wa anata, ono naka ataimasu.
No.
Prettier than her for free.
No.
Just please don't call the police,
no.
Mr. Takeshi.
Sarah, you go.
Sir,
I don't want to see your face again.
Sir, I'm
don't
sorry,
come
sir.
Back here. Get out.
Oh, sir.
Hey.
So how are Kara and the baby doing?
They're sleeping right now.
And you? Don't you need to rest? I'm sure that you're really tired of taking care of both mother and child.
Actually, I'm not tired at all. I'm very happy, though. But at the same time, I'm really nervous.
Nervous? Now, why would you say that?
Dad, I want to do everything for Isabella. And for Kara as well. But I'm afraid that... What if I fail? Or what if I do something wrong? Oh, I just have a lot of things on my mind right now.
You know what, Seb? That's just normal. That's what new fathers feel like. I mean, look at me. I had to take care and deal with twin girls, right? Aside from the babies, I also had to take care of Laura, too.
And that's why I really look up to you. I really admire the sacrifices you've made.
Andrea.
Thank goodness you're here, Sarah. Your baby just stopped crying a moment ago. Hey, what happened? What's with the long face?
I just got fired from work, Andrea.
Oh, no! On top of that, Rebecca's sick. Your baby's running a fever, Sarah.
What? What happened to Rebecca?
I really don't know, but maybe that's why she keeps on crying.
Oh no.
Her fever wasn't this high before.
She's warming up. Quick, let's take her
what?
To the hospital. Hurry, bring my things. Rebecca?
Come on, Sarah, let's go.
No. All right, let's go. Can you get the door?
Okay.
Hang on, baby. Just hang on. Help! Help, please! Please, miss, my baby is sick, please.
Watashi tashi wa akachan no tanemi. Ishoto hitsum yoto shimasu.
Doc, please help my baby. She's crying. She's very hot. Please help me.
Okay, we'll take your baby to the emergency room.
Please.
Nurse, take her to the ER. Okay?
Rebecca.
Okay,
whoa. Sarah, let's stay here. We can wait here, all right?
My baby is sick. What do I do now?
You know, it isn't a sacrifice when it concerns your family. I love Laura very much, and she's the only woman I've ever loved. That's why I can do everything, even being a father to her children. Maybe it was easy for me because our love has always been strong from the start. And that's what you should think about when it comes to Kara and your baby girl.
You know, I love them both very much. I wouldn't trade them for anything in the world.
And if that's so, then you just think about how much you love them. And about how strong your love is that it can conquer your fears. That would be the reason for all the decisions that you will make. As a husband and a father.
Thank you, Dad.
Doc, where's my baby? How is she?
Is she okay?
When the baby was born, she was already fighting germs because her immune system was not fully formed, being a premature baby. The baby had a serious case of measles, and unfortunately, it was too late to save her. You should have taken her here when you first noticed signs of her sickness. But now, I am sorry.
Oh, wait, wait. Doc? No, 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 I don't understand you. Where's my baby? I want to see her. Where's my baby?
I'm sorry. We did our best.
No.
Sarah, Rebecca's
no,
gone.
No, no, she's not. He's lying. Where's my baby, Doc?
Sarah, Sarah.
No, Doc, where's Rebecca? Where's my baby girl? Where's my baby, Doctor? No, he's wrong. No, Doctor,
Sarah, Sarah, Sarah.
Doctor, where's my baby? I want my baby back. Where's my baby, Doctor? I want to see my baby now. Where's my baby, Doctor? Doctor!
It's already morning. You haven't eaten anything. At least get a glass of milk so that there's something in your system. It is what it is. You were just out of luck. Just be thankful that your baby did not suffer for very long.
So can I see my baby now?
Wait a second. Can we see the baby, Doctor?
Doctor, what are the results of the newborn screening?
Upon screening and physical examination of your child, we didn't see any major abnormalities. But we did discover one thing. She has a G6PD deficiency.
What's that, Doctor?
You don't have to worry about it. All we can say for sure right now is that her glucose 6, phosphate dehydrogenase levels, which helps the red blood cells function normally, it's not enough in her. This condition is an inborn metabolic disorder.
Is it dangerous, Doctor? Is there anything we need to do? Or is there any kind of medication we have to give her?
There's no need to worry, ma'am. This is a simple condition and the baby is not at risk at all. As long as you avoid prohibited foods, medicines, and beverages that would aggravate it, I think she will be fine. Here's the list of things that you should avoid. As far as food is concerned, she must avoid eating beans such as mung beans, sweet tofu, and soya. If you neglect to do so, it may lead to severe anemia. But if we're aware of what's not good for her, we can prevent any complications.
All right, thank you, Doctor. I will consider everything you just told us. And we will keep in touch, especially for monthly checkups.
No problem. You can call me anytime regarding your baby. And again, you have nothing to worry about.
Thank you, Doctor.
Your mother is here. Maybe Mother's right here. Please don't leave Mother. Wait. Wait, what are you doing? Wait. Wait, wait, bring back my baby. Sir, I want to hold my baby. No. Wait, sir, I want to hold
Sarah,
my baby.
Sarah.
Baby.
Sarah, Sarah, calm down. Sarah, try to calm down.
Maybe Mother's here.
my baby. My God.
Sarah.
Oh, this is my
baby.
Please get some rest, okay? I won't go to work. I'll stay right here.
Thanks, Andrea.
Is there anything you want? You just have to ask, okay?
Could I please borrow your cell phone?
Huh? What was that?
Cell phone.
Oh, here you go. Let me just prepare some food for us.
It's a good thing that you guys are back. It's so hot outside.
You said
so,
it.
So, how's our beautiful little baby girl doing, huh?
She's all right, Itoi. The doctor said that there are some foods and medicines that she can't take, but otherwise she's fine.
Nothing to worry about.
Thank goodness for that. Oh, wait a second. Speaking of worrying, Laura, you forgot your phone here at home. Here. And you know what? Someone's been calling you, and I think it's a long-distance call.
I was in a hurry. It was a long-distance call.
See? You should call that number back. That must be Sarah. Maybe she's starting to miss us, right? Or maybe she just wants to talk. I think she misses us, don't you think so? Maybe she's homesick and she wants to go home, right, guys?
That would be a great thing, Itoi.
I can't seem to get through, Itoi. I wonder what's going on.
Rebecca, I'm really sorry that I can't keep all of your ashes. But somehow through this necklace, one way or another, I'll always feel your presence.
Why did you have to leave me, Rebecca? Why did you have to leave your mother? I love you very much. I'll miss you, Rebecca. Don't you forget your mother, all right?
Aren't you going to sleep yet?
In a few minutes.
I suppose you're hoping she'd call again, right?
It was Sarah who called. I'm sure it was her. And I'm worried right now.
And why are you worried, Laura?
You know our daughter, Ishmael. She's really proud. And she only backs down when she's feeling scared. Which is why I'm worried. Why did she call? Something might be wrong.
Well, maybe she just wanted to tell us that she already gave birth.
Then why isn't she picking up her phone? And why hasn't she called back yet?
Laura, you were once a new mother too. Maybe she's too busy taking care of her child. Or maybe she just doesn't have enough time to call. Taking care of a baby isn't easy, you know.
Why doesn't she just come back home anyway? So we can stop worrying about her. I really hope that she'll change her mind soon.
Come here. Let's just leave her be, okay? Let's give her some space right now. Because I believe that one day, Sarah will come home to us.
Have you really made up your mind? Maybe you can still stay on, Sarah. Why don't you try finishing what you've started here?
Before there's too much regret to bear. I would rather stop. I can't stay here anymore.
Why is that? Can you bear your life in the Philippines? But didn't you tell me that you came to Japan because you had nobody to go back to in the Philippines? What would you do there for work?
I don't know. I just don't know. What I do know is that I need to go. After everything that's happened to me here, I want to leave.
So you're going back to your family now?
Why is it so easy for you to make her stop crying? Oh, I'm going to top that, Laura. Because next time, Kara, I'll do a production number, and I'll make sure that Isabella stops crying forever.
Come on, do you really have to do a production number?
So that's what you want us to do, to talk to you and tickle you? You're so fuzzy, baby girl. And I'm so exhausted. And to give me a massage.
Isabella. Itoy, can I borrow your fan for
it's
a
really
moment?
It's really hot today,
isn't Yes, you're not kidding.
Oh, Seb, what's that?
Well, these are for Isabella. I bought these earlier.
So he went shopping again. He sure likes shopping.
Here. It's a guardian angel pin.
Hold on! I know that one! Laura! Remember Karen and Sarah used to have those pins as well?
That's right.
You know, to ward off the evil eye.
Oh, you're right, Ethan.
Am I right?
Yes, you're right. Pin it on her. Pin it.
Do you like it?
Someone likes her dad's present.
At least she's not crying anymore. Oh, look, she's smiling.
Look at that. Ooh, hey, baby girl.
It's like she's screaming when she cries. From today on, I'll start calling her Isabella Belter. She yells when she cries, no matter what time of the day it is. But still, her mom and dad are here and they love her very much. You know, I'm totally sure that if Sarah were here with us, she would be so envious again.
No, she wouldn't.
Just kidding. But it was funny, right?
Now how can I go back? When you're all very happy, while I'm still a big loser who's grieving. How can I get over all my painful experiences when Kara is around to remind me of all the wrong decisions I've made?